Hi, Joel. Hi,
Hi, Sagaita.
Good afternoon to everybody. Thank you for having me.
Yeah, you know, I asked you this, but I want to ask it again because I'm sure the audience is curious. What exactly is that behind you?
Ay, nako, that's part of my peppermill collection. I have a kind of a huge collection that I started 32 years ago when I went to Italy in 1986 to take my first kind of cooking course there. And since then, I've collected very unique peppermills through the years. So I think I may have about 170 plus in my collection.
Oh, wow. Oh,
they used to be displayed at Pepato, my signature restaurant, long ago, but now they're here na lang in my office at home.
Okay, great, great. Really talagang foodie ka, hindi makapagkakaila. Anyway, you have a lot of restaurants, you have a lot of things that on your shoulder, so I know you were hit bad by the pandemic. I'd like you to share your experience with our audience. I'll give you a minute, chef.
Well, if you notice the logos of everyone in the crawler in the bottom, the logo, the brand that I chose to display is our catering brand, which is Cibo Di Marghi, because I think that this is probably the brand that's most challenged during this whole pandemic situation. Cibo as well has 16 doors. But it's been a little bit challenging to open them all. We've only opened 10 as of yesterday. And we still don't know if it's the best idea to keep as many stores open, because then we need to see how people respond. Apart from that, of course, there's Grace Park, Luzon, Islas Pinas, which is even more challenged because it's all the way in the area of the boulevard, where I think people are very afraid to go out, no? And overall, we've had to reinvent ourselves to do takeout and delivery, because that's all that's allowed for the moment. And at the same time, our front of house staff, many of them have shifted into our courier team. So the ones that have the motorcycles are helping us deliver the food. Others are driving, while the others are even helping us package food in the commissary.
Oh, I mean, I don't know if that's good news that you're operating pa rin kahit papano, but I'm sure you're not operating at the same level as before.
Yeah. Huh? Definitely not the same level. We're even studying the numbers, for example, of Cibo as a brand, no? We're seeing we'll probably do just 30% of what we normally do. So
it's
super challenging. The catering, we don't even know. We have wedding clients who have obviously canceled. And we don't know how soon the catering business will resume. But what we're doing is we're offering custom-made menus for our clients so that they can have our catering food at home. We have to keep reinventing ourselves. We beefed up our bakery. So, you know, I'm doing my crinkles, which is great because it now has like a waiting line a little bit because we can't produce enough. And then we also
Margarita Fores crinkles.
Yes, our crinkles are the original old ADB crinkles. So, madaming storya yan, but it's the original crinkles of ADB from siguro mga 5 years ago. And we're taking orders on that. And then we're also doing a provincia style, super soft, pillowy, and semada in different flavors. So we're beefing up the bakery part. We're doing breads because that's what people want today. And I guess you just have to be quick and resilient, no, to turn around. And as they say, the new keyword is pivot. And that's what we're doing.
Okay. Correct, correct. Before I let you go, I just have this one question. Patay na nga ba ang buffet?
Mukhang for now, kailangan patay na. Because it's also kind of become jaded as the biggest cause of spread, right? Especially on the cruise ships. That's what the story was that got around. So we need to be able to serve our food differently. Maybe, you know, first, apart from plating the food, maybe if we do Russian service and our service staff definitely has the mask and the gloves, maybe that might work out better. But I think that that's still kind of a little bit distant because people are not allowed still to get together more than 10 people, di ba? All at once.
Correct.
So we're waiting. We're also getting ourselves ready to see what kind of safety, food safety restrictions we should be able to implement.